The initiative in this first Investec Ashes Test had swung England's way on the third day at Trent Bridge, thanks to an unbroken seventh wicket stand of 108 between Stuart Broad and Ian Bell. Australia were furious, believing they had ended that partnership, when Broad edged behind on 37, only to stand his ground, and umpire Alim Dar refused to raise his finger. The pair went on to the close with England in charge on 326 for 6 and looking to build on a lead of 261. The tourists certainly seemed unsettled if the first ball of day 4 was anything to go by. Mitchell Starc running in from the Radcliffe Road end was hoping to make a statement of intent. This surely wasn't what he had in mind. A beamer so wide it went for 5 no balls. Resuming on 47 not out, Broad soon made the most of yesterday's controversial reprieve by reaching the 10th half century of his Test career. And in the next over, it was Bell's turn to celebrate his 18th Test century, surely one of his best and most important given the context of the match. 237 balls it took him to reach 3 figures, having anchored England's second innings superbly. The partnership was finally broken for 138 when Broad thick edge behind off James Pattinson, through to Brad Haddin, and this time he was walking off after a comfortable take from the keeper. But a very valuable 65 from Broad in front of his home crowd. And England's lead was past 300 before Australia struck again just under half an hour later. The end of Bell's brilliant innings for 109 after a fine ball from Starc around the wicket. But Bell left the field hoping he'd already made a match-winning contribution. From that point, it didn't take Australia long to mop up the tail. Graham Swan edging to slip off Peter Siddle. And captain Michael Clark beat Shane Watson to the catch. Swan gone for 9. And just 2 balls later came the end of the innings. No last man heroics from England, as Jimmy Anderson clipped to catch the Philip Hughes to give Siddle his 8th wicket of the match. The home side all out for 375. It means Australia are set 311 to win, a bigger total than any Test team has ever successfully chased down at Trent Bridge. The tourists still had a testing spell to survive before lunch as they set about tackling the tallest of orders, but they did so in solid style with few scares. Opening Shane Watson and Chris Rogers putting on 28, including 6 boundaries, as they negotiated 7 overs before the interval. So Australia still have all 10 wickets in hand, needing another 283 runs for victory.